The war on corruption remains a thorn in the flesh, even as the Ethics and Anti-Corruption Commission tightens its nose on the perpetrators, with the key challenge being recovery of assets and cash stashed in overseas accounts. It is a hurdle that the anti-graft body says it has adequately prepared to surmount. The anti-graft agency is looking at working with its regional counterparts in tracing billions of shillings that have illegally found their way outside the country.
It begins with information, because first of all you need to know what you are looking for, and who, how much, where it is. But also it goes within the confines of the law. So legal framework is very critical.
It's a fight that we cannot fight on our own. We cannot just close ourselves within our geographical boundaries and say that we are winning this war. Just like indicated, you find all these, like the assets, they'll be transcending our national borders outside the country, within the region, and even internationally, wherever they'll be. So I think it's very critical that we start building this partnership, and that's why when you see Interpol coming in, it's providing its the international infrastructure that it has in terms of the databases.
Interpol estimates that about $4.7 trillion could have been lost through corruption between 2014 and 2015 in the East African region alone, with the bulk of the proceeds traced to Jersey Islands. EACC CEO Halake Wako admits that it has been challenging, especially with a deficient mechanism on intelligence sharing.
The known destinations have been those islands, the many islands. Talk of Jersey, talk of Guernsey, talk of the Isle of Man, talk of any other. But what people should know also is that a lot is also hidden locally, and a lot is hidden in the region. So we are pursuing all this, but we cannot say it's only in one direction that you have assets that have been taken as stolen from here.
EACC and Interpol are hosting delegates from over 17 countries across the region at the 16th Global Program on Anti-Corruption, Financial Crimes and Asset Recovery in Nairobi. The four-day forum will discuss the challenges, structures and possible legislations required to enhance the fight against corruption as well as asset recovery.